Difference in example number 14, we have draw the graph of the function from real numbers to real number defined by f of x is equal to x cube. So here we are given f of x is equal to x cube. Let us find the values for this. So f of 1 will be, if x is equal to 1, we'll get f of 1 is equal to x cube, means 1 cube, that is equal to 1. For x equal to 2, we will get f of 2, that is equal to 2 cube, that is equal to 2 cube is 2 to the 4 to the 8. If you take x is equal to 3, we will get f of 3, that is equal to 3 cube, and it is 27, and so on. If you take x is equal to minus 1, we will get f of negative 1, that is equal to negative 1 cube, it means we will get a negative 1. Please understand this. This is minus 1 into minus 1 into minus 1 3 times, so it will be negative 1. If you take x is equal to negative 2, you will get f of negative 2 is equal to negative 2 cube, that is equal to negative 8. Now, please note, here x belongs to real number, means x will have all the values, rational values as well as irrational values. So x can have root 2, x can have fractions, x can have negative fractions, x can have positive fractions. Now, if you try to plot the graph, we have already studied that all real numbers can be plotted on the number line. This is what we have already studied. It means, if this is 1, this is 2, root 2 is somewhere here. That is, if you take 1, 1, this side, and you will get a right angle, hypotenuse will be root 2. This distance will be somewhere here, 1.4142, something like this. So, root 2 can also be plotted on the number line. This is what we have studied. 3. If you plot this side, it will be negative 1, negative 2, negative 3. This side positive 1, positive 2, positive 3, positive 4. This is y axis, this is x axis, the origin. This will be negative 1, negative 2, negative 3, negative 4, and so on. Now, if you try to plot, if x is equal to 1, we get f of 1 is equal to 1. This y is equal to f of x, means we take f of x on y-axis and x values on x-axis. So for 1 we have 1, please note. For 2 we have 8, it will go somewhere here. So it is very large number. Then if you take negative 1, you will get here. For 0, f of 0 is equal to, for x is equal to 0, you get f of 0 cube, f of 0 is equal to 0 cube, that is equal to 0. So for 0, you will get 0. It means, if you try to plot the graph, you will get something like this. For 2, it will be negative 8. So it will be double of this. You try to understand. So if you try to plot the graph, it will be in first quadrant and third quadrant. This is first quadrant and third quadrant. So here you will understand that domain is a real number, then range is also a real number, and if you try to plot the graph, we will get in first quadrant and the third quadrant. Understand this. For 2 we will have the value somewhere 8. If you take it, extend this, you will get it 8. So graph is something like this. Next point is rational functions. The functions of the type f of x upon g of x. We have already studied the definition of the rational numbers. Rational numbers are the numbers which are in the form of p upon q, where p and q are integers, and q is not equal to zero integer. Now, here also the functions of the type f of x upon g of x, where f of x and g of x are polynomial functions. So these are polynomials. F of x and g of x are polynomials, and defined functions of x defined in a domain. So this will be defined in the domain where g of x is not equal to 0. We already know, in any fraction, if the denominator becomes 0, the fraction becomes undefined. The value is not defined. Here, let us try to understand. If you take 1 upon 10, we will get some value 0.1. If you take 1 upon 100, we will get the value 0.01. Please understand this. If you take 1 upon 10,000, we will get 0.3 zeros. Now, let us try to understand what is happening. Here, if denominator increases, the value approaches, the value goes to zero. If you decrease this, if we decrease the denominator, let us see what happens. If you take 0 upon 0.1, we will get the values 10 upon 1 by shifting the decimal point, this will be 10. If you take 1 upon 0.01, this will be 100. If you take 1 upon 0.0001, we will get 10,000. Now, let us see what is happening. If the denominator goes on decreasing, the value goes on increasing. If you take 1 upon 0.00000, a very large number, or sorry, very small number, it is 0.00000001, then it means the number denominator is very small. We will get some value which is very large. If this denominator becomes exactly zero, then this 1 upon 0 will be so large number that we won't be able to write it. It means this is undefined. So if you take 1 upon 0, this will be undefined, or we cannot write the number in numerical form. Thus, we need to understand that denominator can never be zero in case of rational functions. The functions, again I am repeating the definition, the functions of the type f of x upon g of x, where f of x and g of x are the polynomials. These are the two polynomial functions defined in domain. So x will be defined in the domain, but the denominator must never be equal to 0. So g of x must not be 0. It means x in domain, x will have all the values of the real number minus 0, but not the 0 value. It means x will have all the values of real numbers other than 0. If it becomes 0, then this rational function becomes undefined. Next is example number 15. Define the real valued function from real numbers but not 0 to real numbers defined by f of x is equal to 1 upon x. So we are given a rational function which is in numerator upon denominator form, that is 1 upon x. X belongs to real numbers other than 0. Please understand this. X is a real number but not the 0. Complete the table given below using this definition. So using this definition, f of x is equal to 1 of x, we have to complete the table which is given. What is the domain and range of this function? We are asked what is the domain and range of this function. Now, let us see. When x is equal to negative 2, we will get f of x is equal to 1 upon x. That is y's value. That is equal to 1 upon negative 2. It means it is, please understand, this is negative. So, fraction is negative means this is negative, and 1 upon 2 is 0.5. So, we will get the value 0.5. But it will be negative. Next is, if x is equal to negative half, then we will get f of x is equal to 1 upon minus 1.5. So this will be negative. You can, if you multiply this by, you will get 10 upon 15. 10 upon 15 means this is equal to 2 upon 3. So if you divide 2 upon 3, that is, if you divide by 5, you will get 2 upon 3. 2 upon 3 means 3, you will get, this is negative, this is also negative, this will also be negative. You will get the 20 divided 6, 3 is 18, 0.6666 recurring. It can be written as 0.67 negative value. So this will have the value 0.67 negative. Next is, if x is equal to negative 1, then f of x is equal to 1 upon negative 1, that is equal to negative 1 itself. So it will be again negative 1. If you take 0.5, x is equal to 0.5, then you will get f of x is equal to 1 upon 0.5. This is a positive value. So if you multiply by 2, you will get 10 upon 5, that is equal to 2. So value will be 2. If you take this, it is negative 0.5. So this will be negative 2. Next is 0.25. So 0.25, if you try to calculate, you will get 1 upon 0.25. I am writing directly. If this will be 100 upon 25, means 4. So this will have the value 4. This will have a positive 2. This will have a 1. 1.5 we have already divided. 0.67. 2 is already divided. We will have the value 0.5. But this will be positive values. So this is y is equal to 1 upon x. What is the domain and range of this function? We are already told, define a real valued function. Means it will have all the real values which can be defined. That is, all the real values other than 0. So this will have domain. Domain is equal to, domain of this function will be, domain is equal to all the values of real numbers other than 0. And range is also same. Range will also have the values of all the real numbers but not the 0. So other than 0, all real numbers will be included in domain as well as range.